Today I'm going to show you how to make an avatar for your Google site. First of all, I've opened up Photoshop and I can see that the last person that used this left palettes all over the place and it looks kind of messy. So what I'm going to do is go to Window, Workspace, Essentials, and that will put all of my basic palettes back on the side and clean up the desktop. So I'm going to go to File, Open, and navigate to an image that I want to use for my avatar. So avatars in general are really small and they're usually square. So we're going to make ours square. Over here in the toolbox on the left side, I'm going to select the second tool down, which is the Marquee tool. If we look at the options on the top, you can see that they've changed according to whatever tool I have selected. So all of the settings here are where they're supposed to be. Style is on normal. Once in a while, someone will change one of these settings and the tool won't work the way it's supposed to. And you might not realize at first it's because somebody changed something up here. So we are going to need to have this on normal. And I want the bird part to be my picture. And because this is a rectangle, I'm going to have to cut part of it off to make it a square. So with the Marquee tool, if you hold down Shift, it will constrain it to be only a square shape. So I'm going to click and drag around the bird. And while I'm holding down Shift, if I also hold down the space bar, then I can actually move the little square around and position it exactly where I want it. So I want part of the bird's beak, and I'll get the tail, hold down the space bar, move it around, and that looks pretty good right there. So let go of the mouse, then let go of Shift and the space bar. And then I'm going to go up here to the menu at the top and go to Image Crop. So that made this a square, but now I need to make it the right size. So I'm going to go to Image Size, and our avatars are going to be 80 pixels. First of all, make sure that this says pixels and not inches or percent. So if it says something else, just change it back to where it says pixels. I'm going to highlight this number and type in 80, and you'll see that the bottom number automatically changed to match the top number. That's because these boxes down here are checked, which means Photoshop is keeping it proportionate. So I'll click OK, and you can see it's really tiny. I'm actually going to get the zoom tool down here at the bottom of the toolbox and click Actual Pixels. So that's what size my avatar is. And I think this is going to work. You can tell it's a bird, and I think it's recognizable. If your image is too small or it kind of just turns into a blob and you can't really tell what it is, then maybe that image isn't appropriate for the avatar and you should choose a different one. So you're going to have to use your judgment for that. Now what I'm going to do is go to File, Save As, and anything that is on going to be posted to a website has to be a JPEG. So I'm going to call this Avatar Justine, and the file format is already on JPEG, so I don't have to change it. But if you do have to change it, you just click this menu down here and you change it to the file format that you need. And I will click Save. And let's go ahead and go with a quality of about 6 and click OK. Now this avatar is ready to be inserted onto the Google site. That's it for now.